In this video, you will learn how to store and manage logins to other systems centrally on KNIME Business Hub. Most workflows involve at least one connection to a data source, for example, to access or load the data. And most of the time, to establish such a connection, you need to authenticate against the data source. A good way to manage logins within a workflow is to provide credentials once in the credentials configuration node, and then use the encrypted variable in all the nodes that need the credentials. If you need multiple connections, you can create a component with multiple credentials configuration nodes inside. Once you upload the workflow to KNIME Business Hub, it might be visible to others, for example, to team members with access to the space. If your workflow uses your private credentials, you might then need an additional layer of security on the top of the password encryption provided by the credentials configuration node. On the other hand, if your workflow uses the credentials shared with multiple team members, it might be useful to store them in a central location for the team members to have access to the up-to-date credentials. This is where the KNIME Business Hub secrets can help. What does a secret mean on KNIME Business Hub? A secret is any kind of login to other systems centrally stored on KNIME Business Hub. KNIME Business Hub supports different types of secrets, from classic username and password credentials, to access tokens, to generic OAuth 2, to provider specialized logins, and probably more are being added right now as we speak. KNIME Business Hub secrets can be owned and managed either by a user or by a team. User secrets are personal user logins. You can manage them from your profile page. Team secrets are logins shared within a team. A team admin can manage them from the team page. So, how do you use a secret stored on KNIME Business Hub? In short, instead of hardcoding your credentials directly in a workflow, you can store them on KNIME Business Hub and access them in a workflow. This way, the secret is available only to you or to users who have access to the secret, but not necessarily to users who have view rights to the workflow. Let's see an example of how to create and consume a team secret. First, let's create a team secret on KNIME Business Hub. On the team page, select Secrets. To create a new secret, click the plus button. In the new menu, provide a name and the description. Select the type of the secret. For example, let's select the classic username and password option. And enter the credentials and click Create. Now your secret is stored centrally in your team's secret store. To edit or delete a secret later, click the three dots menu and select the relevant option. Here you can also manage who can view and edit the secret. For example, the whole team, or selected team members, or even users from other teams. Let's see what a user sees in their secrets. Here you will see the secrets explicitly shared with you. And here you can also create user secrets for your own usage. Remember that personal secrets cannot be shared with other users. Let's see how to consume this secret in a workflow. In this workflow, the username and the password are provided in the credentials configuration node. Let's change this workflow to consume the credentials from the secret store. Add the secret retriever node to the workflow. To be able to execute this node from a local workflow, you need to first authenticate against the KNIME Business Hub instance with your application password in the KNIME Hub Authenticator node. Once authenticated, connect to the secret retriever node and select the secret in the configuration. Once the node is executed, the secret is available as an encrypted flow variable. You can now use this flow variable to authenticate by supplying it to the credentials configuration node or to the connector node directly. This way, by authenticating against KNIME Business Hub, you can now access external systems such as SharePoint, Google Drive, Box, and many more from the workflow. When you upload the workflow to a space on KNIME Business Hub, you can execute the secret retriever node also without the KNIME Hub authenticator node if the user who creates a deployment or an ad hoc execution has access to the secret. In this video, you have learned how to store and manage logins to other systems on KNIME Business Hub and how to access them and consume them from local workflows and workflows running on KNIME Business Hub.